For when you were the servants of sin, you were free from righteousness. What fruit had ye then in those things whereof ye are now ashamed? For the end of those things is death. But now, being made free from sin and become servants to God, ye have your fruit unto holiness, in the end everlasting life. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. For we know that the whole creation groaneth and travaileth in pain together until now. While I was in the body in which I was snatched up to the third heaven, the word of the Lord came to me, saying, Speak to the people, until when will ye transgress and heap sin upon sin and tempt the Lord who made you? Ye are the sons of God, doing the works of the devil. In the faith of Christ, on account of the impediments of the world, remember therefore, and know that while every creature serves God, the human race alone sins, but it reigns over every creature and sins more than all nature. For indeed the sun, the great light, often addressed the Lord, saying, Lord God Almighty, I look out upon the impieties and the injustices of men. Permit me, and I shall do unto them what are my powers, that they may know that thou art God alone. And there came a voice saying unto him,
I know all these things, for mine eyes see and my ears hear. But my patience bears them until they should be converted and repent. But if they do not return unto me, I will judge them all.
The words of the blessing of Enoch, wherewith he blessed the elect and the righteous, who will be living in a day of tribulation when all the wicked and godless are to be removed. And he took up his parable and said, Enoch, a righteous man, whose eyes were opened by God, saw the vision of the Holy One in the heavens, which the angel showed me. And from them I heard everything, and from them I understood as I saw. But not for this generation, but for a remote one which is for to come. Concerning the elect, I said, and took up my parable concerning them. The Holy Great One will come forth from his dwelling, and the eternal God will tread upon the earth, even on Mount Sinai, and appear from his camp, and appear in the strength of his might from the heaven of heavens. And all shall be smitten with fear, and the watchers shall quake, and great fear and trembling shall seize them unto the ends of the earth. And the high mountains shall be shaken, and the high hills shall be made low, and shall melt like wax before the flame. And the earth shall be wholly rent asunder, and all that is upon the earth shall perish. And there shall be judgment upon all men, but with the righteous he will make peace, and will protect the elect, and mercy shall be upon them. And they shall all belong to God, and they shall be prospered, and they shall all be blessed, and he will help them all, and light shall appear unto them. He will make peace with them. And behold, he cometh with 10,000s of his holy ones to execute judgment upon all, and to destroy all the ungodly, and to convict all flesh and all the works of their ungodliness which they have ungodly committed, and all the hard things which ungodly sinners have spoken against him.
My son Methuselah, I will show thee my visions, which I have seen, recounting them before thee. The two visions I saw before I took a wife, and the one who was quite unlike the other. The first was when I was learning to write, the second before I took thy mother, when I saw a terrible vision. And regarding them, I prayed to the Lord. I had laid me down, house of my grandfather, Mahalalel, when I saw in a vision how the heaven collapsed and was borne off and fell to the earth. And when it fell to the earth, I saw how the earth was swallowed up in a great abyss, and mountains were suspended on mountains, and hills sank down on hills, and high trees were rent from their stems and hurled down and sunk into the abyss. And thereupon a word fell into my mouth, and I lifted up my voice to cry aloud and said, the earth is destroyed. And my grandfather Mahalalel waked me as I lay near him, and he said unto me, why dost thou cry so, my son? And why dost thou make such lamentation? And I recounted to him the whole vision which I had seen. And he said unto me, a terrible thing hast thou seen, my son. In a grave moment is thy dream and vision. As to the secrets of all the sin of the earth, it must sink into the abyss and be destroyed with great destruction.